I'm Vanilla. In this video, I'm going to answer two important questions. Why do we need to store electricity and how can we use sand to store electricity? I often come across a question in Facebook and WhatsApp saying, could you live here without internet for 1 month? Share if you can. It's very difficult. But the real question would be, could you live without electricity even for a week? That would be a horrible week. The electricity has become one of the essentials in our day-to-day life. We are blessed to have a gigantic power grid that supplies electricity that we need for lighting, heating, cooling, refrigeration, and for all our entertainment purposes. Around 70% of our electricity comes from thermal power plant. In thermal power plant, the heat energy is converted into electrical energy. In most cases, this heat energy is produced by burning fossil fuels such as coal and natural gas. There are two main problems with this thermal power plant. First, if we keep burning fossil fuels at our current rate, it is generally estimated that all our fossil fuels will be depleted in near future. Second, burning fossil fuel releases carbon dioxide into our atmosphere, which is responsible for the climate change. You may wonder, if this is dangerous and if everyone knows this, why are still thermal power plants working? Shutting down the thermal power plant is not that easy to implement. Let me explain one of the complications involved in this shutting down process. As I said earlier, 70% of our electricity comes from thermal power plant. So before shutting down the thermal power plant, we need to find a replacement. Replacement that doesn't affect the environment and that which uses resources that are freely available on Earth. The two main resources that could replace the fossil fuels are solar energy and wind energy. The problem with solar panels is we cannot generate electricity during nighttime. During cloudy days, the electricity generation will be low. Similarly, with wind turbines, the amount of electricity generation is not constant every time. It depends on the wind speed. We get more electricity on a windy day and much less on a calm day. We cannot ask the people not to use air conditioners or fans or heaters in nighttime just because we cannot generate electricity using solar panels at night. Similarly, we cannot expect people not to use refrigerators nor charge their mobile phones just because the wind speed is low that day. We need electricity throughout the year in all seasons. If we can store the excess electricity produced by the solar panels when the sun shines and from the wind turbines during the windy season, then the stored power can be used whenever the electricity generation is low. But the problem is we don't have such giant battery to store the excess electricity. We do have lithium-ion batteries, the same battery that is used in your mobile phones and electric cars. But they are expensive. There are lots and lots of research going on in energy storage technology. One of the methods is to store energy in sand. Everyone must have visited beach. It's a great place to have fun and relax. Before you get to the water, you will have to walk through the sand. During summer, in the middle of the day, you might have realized that the sand gets extremely hot. At night, when the sun goes down, the sand cools. But if we store this hot sand in an insulated concrete container, then this sand will remain hot for long duration. Researchers at National Renewable Energy Laboratory use this concept to store electricity. Let me explain this simple concept. We know that some elements generate heat when current flows through. Those elements are referred as electric resistive heating elements. If we power this element with the excess electricity produced by solar and wind, they generate enormous heat. When sand is fed through this element, the temperature of the sand will increase. They can be heated around 1200 degrees Celsius and can be stored in an insulated concrete container. When we need electricity, this extremely hot sun can be used to generate hot steam. This steam runs the turbine that is coupled with the generator that generates electricity. That's how a typical thermal power plants work. But the only difference is, instead of burned coal to generate heat, we are using the heat from the stored hot sand. Now, you may wonder why we are using sand. Why don't we just store some hot water? Boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Beyond this point, water turns to water vapor. You could store the water at high temperature beyond 100 degrees Celsius in high pressurized environment without turning it into steam. But for that, we need high pressurized vessels, which are expensive. While sand, on the other hand, is extremely cheap. The sand melts only at 1700 degrees Celsius, which gives us lots of room to store very high heat. Sand can also be heated through concentrating solar power. It uses mirrors to concentrate the sun's energy towards the central tower that acts as a receiver. The concentrated sunlight heats the sand, which is placed inside the receiver. The heat energy stored in the sand can be converted into electrical energy during night time or whenever the electricity demand is more. As the demand is increasing day by day, the engineers are trying to generate clean electricity in all possible ways. They are even trying to bring electricity from space. I would highly recommend you to watch this interesting video, which explains about space-based solar power. Bye, see you in my next video.